Hello guys, Silver Butterflies here. Wanted to brag. I bought old perfume, but I never had it before, so I decided to show you. This is Paloma Picasso, Eau de Toilette version, and it's so much lighter than the original, the classic one. This is Eau de Parfum. Or like all the toilet perfum, and there is another version exactly the same, but the window here not transparent, it's black. So I want to have that as well. Maybe one day if I find it, I'll buy it. So I applied this on my left hand and this one is on my right hand, just for comparison. And what I'm gonna say to you, they both created in 1984. And this one is so much lighter version, which is wearable right now, wearable in 2020. And this one will bring you back to 1984, when everyone used to smoke in a restaurant and a bar, and you have to declare about yourself, otherwise how they will find you. So this one to me personally is like flowers, honey, very light airy version of this one, which is quite heavy and more animalic. This is what is the difference between them. There is also animalic scent here, but in a way like very soft version, but here is more distinct. It's like more you know, I would say not aggressive, but more declaring about. I like both, and I used to love this one, but for some reason I use it less and less. I hardly ever use it. I just come home if I want to be by myself, just dream or something. I smell it sometimes, but not apply it to myself. Apply it on myself. So the yellow version, this light version, is woody, floral, aromatic, green, and musky. The black version is woody, musky, floral, earthy, and aromatic. See, this is the earthy smell here, which is make it more heavier. And frankly, earth and earthy notes is very favorite of mine. But for some reason, I give the preference for this one, because it's like nowadays there's so many different directions of perfumery and so many different niche companies, artisanal, you name it, and so many variety to choose from, so you can be picky. And imagine yourself in 84, that would be totally different vibe. So for me now, I would wear it with very big pleasure, because it's honey, and it's actually not even a honey, it's a flower, narrowly, which gives you that vibe. So I read a little bit of notes for the black ones. Wow, it's huge pyramid. And of course in the beginning it's carnation, which is the feature of that time. And then middle, hyacinth, mimosa, patchouli, ylang ylang, and jasmine. So the base, it's a little bit of oak moss and castoreum. I'm talking about this one. That's why it gives you so heaviness, right? And here, May rose, jasmine, hyacinth, ylang ylang, lily of the valley, mimosa. See, it's more, so much softer. And and sandalwood, vetiver, oak moss, amber. What is this? Musk and civet. So civet it at the end. So it's not that animalic compared to previous one. So I wonder, maybe Paloma Picasso was so ahead of her time. One, she created as a classic, as a demand for that time, and one is for future tense, which is now. And this is more verbal than this, although this is so much richer than this. Some people bought this and wasn't impressed at all. I bought it for the sake of my collection. I love it, and I'm not gonna use it that often, but more than sure, I use this right now in winter, and this one I will smell in winter. This is for me both kind of more winter perfumes, because I cannot imagine this one in a heavy, like in a very, you know, very warm weather of summer. So that would be it for now. This is my little reportage about Paloma Picasso perfumes. I have one more, which is Temptation, and you saw that in my reportage. So see you later. All the best, guys. Tell me what you think, if anybody have it. So all the best. Bye for now.